हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। माई सेल्फ दीपक कुमार पुष्टि फ्रॉम मॉडर्न इंग्लिश स्कूल कुंती नगर नवादापुरा। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ द फर्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ क्लास 5, दैट इज आवर कंप्यूटर सॉफ्टवेयर। द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस सम ऑफ द हार्डवेयर कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द कंप्यूटर सिस्टम, दैट पार्ट we have already discussed, and if you have doubt in the second chapter exercise question, you can ask me, and all of you try to do the chapter 2 exercise questions. Okay, the students, now I will discuss the first what do you mean by software, then we will discuss the types of the software. The students, the software or why we need software. Students, when you run the computer or when you are putting the computer, in that time we need software. After computer is starting on, you do some work, that means to perform a particular task or to do some operate, we need also software. That means from the starting to end, what you do in the computer, in every time we need the software. Without the software, computer can never do anything. Okay student, so for the computer we need both, one is your user, another one is your software. Okay student, the student, for the software we need the first word. So first of all we will discuss what the user gives the instruction to the computer. Okay students, because computer can only understand user's instruction to the computer. Okay, so user's instruction, that means student, for the software, first of all we know that the word set of instructions, need the set of instructions which can be run top to bottom, one after another. Okay students, that means for the software, first of all we need the instruction. The set of instructions is called, the set of instructions is called program. Then set of programs is called software. Okay students, it's called software. In this way, if the definition will come, what is software? So you just simply write for the class 5, software is a collection of program for performing a particular task or controls the components of the computer system. Is that clear students? So instructions, that means what you write or type by the keyboard, that one is a user's instruction. That user instruction can only understand the computer, or computer can only understand the user's instructions. Is that clear? That instruction, when that the collection of the instruction to perform a one program. Is that clear? The set of instruction to form one program, and the set of program to form one software. Is that clear to the students? So in this way you can define what do you mean by software. The student, by the help of the software we are doing everything. That means suppose make a document or make a file, store or what, insert, delete, rename, everything each and every situation we need software students. Is that clear or not, student? The student, for the software, okay student, for the software, why we are using the software? Okay student, question, why we are using, need of software in the computer system. Okay student, so student, the first one, okay student, that one is about controls input or it controls the input or output instruction. Controls input or output instruction from the computer. Okay student, the first one, it controls input or output instruction to or from the computer. Means from the computer, suppose you want to take or give the instruction to the computer. Both are required for the word processing. How it will make the process by the software? That means when you give the instruction or take the instruction from the computer, first of all it will be processed inside the computer. What you want to open? Suppose I want to open one of the document from the computer. That means that is also what? One type of the instruction. Immediately that instruction has transferred to the operating system. That operating system will check and will decide. After that, they will give the output to us. Is that clear or not? That is our first point. The second point, that controls the memory of computer. Means in the why memory is used, store the data or store the information for the long period of a time. Is that clear or not? What you store the data or information in the computer for the long period of a time? We need the memory. That inside the memory, so many types of informations are stored. Okay? To manage that one, to control that one by using software. Is that clear or not? That's why controls the memory of a computer. Is that clear? Then third one, is your word controls. Controls the processing. Controls the processing data in the computer. That means where it will be processed, inside the CPU, data will be processed, but it will be managed or controlled by the operating system. The student, if question will come, why software is needed for the computer system, then you write these 3 points. Controls input or output instruction to or from the computer system. Second one, controls the memory of computer. Third one, controls the processing data. Is that clear or not? Is that clear? So in this way, for this type of the reason, we must need software. Okay student, you are watching movie from your computer or you are listening the music, yes or no? In listening the music, we need multimedia software. Watching movie, we need the multimedia software. That means multimedia software. That means what you want to do, we must need the software. Okay, students, multimedia software. That means we watch the video, listening the music. We must need the multimedia software. Is that clear? So remember, students, this software is the most important part. Without the hardware, software will not run. Or without the software, hardware also will not work. So both are needed for running the computer system in a smoothly. Okay, students. That means to run the computer, we need the software. We need the CPU. If CPU is there and software is not with you, then you cannot run the computer. You have software, but you are not any type of CD-ROM or DVD-ROM, CD player, DVD player, or not. You have not any type of CPU. That means you cannot run your computer. The students, both have most necessary for the computer. Both are related to each other. Hardware dependent on the software. Software is also dependent on the hardware. In this way, computer can run in a very smoothly. Is that clear? So students, so we are going to discuss what you mean by software and why we are using software. Is that clear? In the next, we will discuss the students types of software. Okay, student, because according to the user usage, the software can be divided into different types. We'll discuss that one. In the next class, we'll discuss the types of software. Okay, student, so remember this type of the points, and if you have doubt, then ask me. Okay, thank you.